Today, I am going to speak to you about a subject that I don't feel has been given enough importance or discussion in the industry with regards to lubricant maintenance. We'll first discuss lubricant maintenance for the dry powder ferrous wire drawing lubricants, and then I'll touch on the wet lubricants for the fine ferrous wire drawing, copper drawing, and aluminum drawing. With the dry powder lubricants, once the lubricant is being used, we find that there is lubricant depletion that will require additions to the lubricant box. If pre-coats are being used, what we find is that a lot of the pre-coat comes off in the soap box, diluting the lubricant that we started with so that the lubricant composition has changed again. During the process, temperatures are very high, and we wind up sometimes with a lot of burnt lubricant being generated in the soap box. Other times, we have melted lubricant coming back into the soap box. In mechanical descaling applications, if the cleaning is not complete, scale dust can start accumulating in the soap box, which will cause scratching and higher dye wear. And then there are other numerous contaminations that can find its way into the soap box. Foremost is the ability of the lubricant to get into the soap box. And this means that the lubricant has to flow properly and that there needs to be room in the soap box to allow this movement. What you see in this video is the wire coming through the soap box in this direction. What we see also is that the lubricant is building up at the end of the soap box from the action of the wire. Now, if you look closely, you see the lubricant falling down onto the wire. And so what we have here is a circular flow. Lubricant comes over to the end of the box, moves its way up, and then falls back down, and we have this continuous rotation. Without this rotation, we can develop a situation called tunneling, in which the area around the wire has been vacated of lubricant, and now you're not pulling any lubricant into the dye, and you wind up with lack of lubrication and increased dye wear. As I indicated previously, you can have a situation where if the operators are not observant, where the lubricant gets completely depleted from the lubricant box and you wind up with an empty box and again, lack of lubrication. As I indicated previously, we want to leave enough room in the soap box for the lubricant to flow properly. In this situation where the lubricant box is overfilled, we're not leaving enough room for the lubricant to flow. As the lubricant moves, or as the lubricant gets built up in the front of the box, it's going to have a tendency to overflow and wind up on the draw bench. At the same time, we run the risk of compaction if we're using a fine lubricant powder. And again, that leads to tunneling. This becomes a problem, especially when the soap boxes are covered in order to control unwanted dust formation. This is a situation in which the lubricant has been melting back into the box, and again, it is inhibiting the flow of good lubricant into the box. This meltback is very hard, does not break up easily. Obviously, it's too big to go into the dye, and so this box really needs to be cleaned out. Here's a another situation that we have to be concerned about with lubricant maintenance and lubricant use, and that is misalignment of the wire going into the box. As we can see inside the circle, this wire is hitting up against the side of the box. It has already cut a groove into the box. Now, this results in a couple of different problems. First of all, we're creating excess stress on the outside of the wire on one side. And like a ribbon that we use to wrap presents, in which we will take a strip of ribbon and run it across a sharp edge to make it curl, we're doing the same thing. And this is going to affect our helix and cast. Secondly, it is rubbing the lubricant off of the wire. We work very hard to put enough lubricant onto the wire so that it makes it through the die and helps with lubrication in the next pass. Without this excess, without this lubricant on the surface, we are reducing our ability to lubricate the dies properly. And then last, we are generating excess metal fines. And as this slide demonstrates, there is a significant amount of hard metal fines inside the dry powder, mixed with the dry powder. And these particles get pulled into the die and again create more friction and lead to lower die life through wear, as well as the possibility of scratching. If we also look carefully, we see a lot of meltback, and that's the result of the higher frictional heat that is generated because of the metal fines. Again, this box probably needs to be cleaned out and fresh lubricant placed in it.
Now let's review some key points from the video.